Hi, my name is John Weaver, and I'm here with Kevin Peterson.
Hello.
Question, what do you see as the role of the visual arts in our mass mediated world, and particularly in your profession?
I think that visual arts are like a big, huge part of selling things, whether it be a product or an idea. And in my particular like industry, which is live sound, live events, more like the light show and video, like IMAG, image magnification, is such a big part of being part of the concert. Rather than just going to and listening to a concert, you get to experience a lot more of it, and it adds quite a bit of emotion. You get to get up right there with the artist. So
with new communications and media technologies, imagery is almost instantly available. Do you believe that this is having a positive or negative influence on the industry? And you could provide an example.
I think that it's definitely a positive thing, because everything now, because everything's instantly available, you want, you know, basically the consumer is looking for here and now. They're looking for like right now, up to date images, and I think that's definitely a good thing that that our industry is able to provide that.
What popular images do you see that are frequently rechanneled throughout the entertainment industry?
Well, if you look at like past the greats from the past, whether like Elvis or Michael Jackson or people like that, you always see people making references to them. I know. So yeah, I think that those icons are being, you know, respected in a way. And I think they're sort of being recycled again and again, which I believe is definitely a good thing.
There are particular images that this industry has popularized and or created that you see?
The first thing that comes to mind when you say that is probably the style, visual style of bands like Pink Floyd, Nirvana, and Metallica, just because you see so many of their t-shirts around, and they're just, you know, even if like the Metallica font, you don't even have to see the word Metallica, you know that it is Metallica, or you don't even have to see the actual words exactly. You just know, hey, that's a Pink Floyd t-shirt, or that's a Nirvana t-shirt, or something like that. So I think those three artists, Metallica, Pink Floyd, and Nirvana, are probably, you know, they really knew what they were doing.
You're getting the list, you know, I just gotta ask, you know, who's one of your favorite visual artists or arts, and or what is your favorite style of visual art?
Well, ever since entering the show production world, I really have a great respect for lighting designers, lighting for concerts or whether it be corporate events or anything along those lines. And I'm a really big fan of Barry Phillips. I think he's a great lighting designer. He's got he's creative, yet he's down to earth at the same time. So I'd say probably Barry Phillips is one of my favorite artists.
Well, he's a cool guy. So, you know, because we're in this art history class, I gotta ask you, you know, how has your knowledge of famous artworks influenced your creative process?
Well, any form of art, whether it be mixing music or directing video or light shows or back, you know, the traditional paint and canvas, it's all just basically springing off of other people's ideas, and some people call this stealing, but I don't think it's stealing unless you know, I think it's just paying tribute to people in the past who have done better works than you, and then eventually you hope to use that and then, you know, take some of what they've done, some of what you've done, and make a brand new image or idea out of that, and then hopefully someone else down the road will look at your work and they'll do the same thing, and eventually it morphs and it adapts to the style of the century or whatever it is that you're going after. So,
well, Kevin, thank you for being such a good sport and playing along with me, and
thank you
being able to answer these questions. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.